This video contains elements that are not suitable for children under the age of 14. Viewer discretion is advised. Hey guys, welcome back. I know it's been a little while, so let's waste no time and get straight to number 5.
Don't you mean number maroon 5?
The Elementary Chronicles. So enthralling, it'll knock you off your feet.
That was awful. Almost as awful as you liking maroon 5 more than Amy Winehouse.
Shut up! I know that it may be hard to believe, but there actually was a point in the past where Maroon 5, also known as Adam Gomez and the Scene, was in fact a real band that made music that was intended to actually make people feel things. They'd never been a bastion of quality or anything like that, but there was a time in the past where I didn't mind Maroon 5 songs at all. I even liked a few of them. But no matter what Maroon 5 does in the future, they're never going to be able to top this. That bass, that synth, that guitar, the fact that you can barely hear Adam Levine being a whiny little dork at all, it just all comes together so perfectly. The groove is just so tight and controlled, not one note falls out of place, and it's just a masterclass in funk rock. But you know what I love most in this? The percussion. I never noticed this until now, but in a ton of Maroon 5 songs, especially the more recent ones, the percussion is almost a total non-presence and fades into the background completely, which results in a sound that has no backbone and no punch to it. While the percussion work in Makes Me Wonder isn't mind-blowing, it does have a spotlight role in the song, with several spots that feature almost no instrumentals besides the drums. Beyond that, though, there really isn't much of a deep, meaningful reason why I enjoy this, other than that it has a funky and awesome sound to it, which is why it blows my mind that, in a world where mainstream music critics seem to hand out critical acclaim like Halloween candy, this song actually seemed to have a polarized reaction. Although there were plenty who loved it just as much as I do, there was a surprising number of people who didn't like this turn from Maroon 5's earlier, more soft stuff, with one critic in particular stating that Makes Me Wonder is so bland that it's offensive. You think that Maroon 5 is too bland now? In this, the year 2007. You got a long decade ahead of you, lady. I feel like we've been a bit spoiled by the fact that we've lived the past decade in a world where Daft Punk is an established part of popular music. For me personally, Daft Punk is one of my favorite musical acts ever, and their collaboration with Strokes frontman Julian Casablancas, Instant Crush, is a very strong contender for my favorite song of all time. Daft Punk is special in that their stuff that gets popular is just as good as the stuff that doesn't, and they don't need to water down their sound at all to go mainstream. But in 2007, nobody in America knew who Daft Punk was. Back then, they weren't some of the greatest electronic hitmakers of all time, they were just those two French robot guys who made weird songs about, you know, Captain Planet's extended family or whatever. Honestly, Daft Punk were still ahead of their time 10 years ago, and if they were going to get any recognition in popular culture, it would have to be from a true visionary who was constantly pushing the boundaries of music into new and uncharted territories. But who could be this unsung musical hero? Who would be the first to recognize the potential of this new type of music and be the visionary genius that leads us forward into the new musical age? Heard they do anything for a Klondike. Well, I'd do anything for a Blondike. Don't ever change, Kanye. Work it, make it, do it. Makes us older, better, faster, stronger. That don't kill me. Can only make us stronger. I need you. much longer. I remember there was once a time in the past where I thought Kanye West was a loudmouth jackass and nothing more than that. However, I've grown a lot since then, and I now realize that Kanye West is a loudmouth jackass and much, much more than that. Real talk, I actually do believe that Kanye West is a genius, a brilliant auteur who blurts out every single thought that comes into his head with no filter whatsoever. His contributions to popular music cannot be overstated, from his work as a revolutionary producer, to the crazy experiments he's pulled out from his last few albums, to what we're talking about today, putting Daft Punk on the pop culture map in the United States. And it's not like Daft Punk were complete unknowns at the time, they'd been around for a decade and a half and they were doing very well for themselves, but Kanye West gave them a number one hit with one of the best songs of both of their careers. This is one of the greatest pump-up anthems of all time, with Kanye doing what he does best. Talking about how awesome he is and that you should be weak at the knees for the sheer fact that he's acknowledging your existence. You should be honored by my lateness, that I would even show up to this fake shit. So go ahead, go nuts, go ape shit. Oh, and for the record, this is a perfect example of sampling done right. Take the original Daft Punk song this is based on, Harder, Better, Faster, Stronger, which is honestly not one of my favorite Daft Punk songs. It's a bit too weak for a title like that, and production-wise, it honestly kind of just sounds like a kid playing with a toy piano and bashing pots and pans together. Work it, make it, do it, makes us. Harder, better, faster, stronger. Kanye then takes this song and does this with it. Man, I've been waiting all night, man. That's how long I've been on ya. That is a much better fit for a song like this. Taking pre-existing elements from other songs and recontextualizing them into something new and different. Two adjectives which describe Kanye West just as well today as they did 11 years ago. Stronger by Kanye West. A great song by a great man. I feel like me and Taylor might still have sex. Why? I made that bitch famous. God damn! Stronger by Kanye West. A great song by Kanye West. When the bow is in the party, everybody put up their hands. I get a half a meal for my beach, you get a couple crap that never gon' see the day that I ain't got the upper hand. I'm respected from California, I ain't way down to Japan. I really don't like doing ties on lists like this, especially between so many songs, but I'm sorry, if I didn't, then Timbaland songs would probably take up at least half of this list. Timbaland was the mid to late 2000s, producing some of the most beloved tracks of the decade with his production style that was very distinctive and yet incredibly different each time. No two Timbaland songs are alike, but you can still instantly identify a Timbaland song when you hear it, which is a truly remarkable feat. 2007 is an excellent portfolio year for the guy, showcasing a wide array of his work both as a lead artist and as a producer for several other artists. Because there are way too many awesome tracks here to just pick one to represent them all, I'm gonna do a mini review of every single song that Timbaland had on the 2007 year-end list, with the exceptions of Apologize and Sexy Back. In no particular order, let's go. This production is just a tad too overcrowded for my taste, but I think this is probably the best example of Timbaland singing this year. He's not a technically good singer by any means, but that multi-layer effect he does here fits in exceptionally well, as does Kerry Hilson, who I typically just find annoying and unnoteworthy. This is a solid track. This production is a worse version of Cry Me a River, but not that much worse, and considering that Cry Me a River is one of Timbaland's all-time greatest beats, this is one of the best beats of 2007. Its laid-back, sultry feel blends in perfectly with Justin's smooth and understated vocals. I might call this one of my favorite Justin Timberlake songs, if not for the fact that it's 7 friggin' minutes long. I'm typically about ready to wrap up by the time the second chorus kicks in. This is probably Nelly Furtado's best song, in no small part thanks to Timbaland's stellar production, which seems to shroud the song in an almost dreamlike, mystical sound that I've never heard reproduced anywhere else. I can't wait to fall in love with you. I think this is my least favorite Timbaland beat of the year, and it's still pretty sweet. Late night to daylight, the club jumping if you want a good time. Oh, yeah, I forgot about this one. Yeah, no, this is Timbaland's worst beat of the year. I can imagine he was told that he was producing a 50 Cent song, so he just decided to slum it for this one. This beat could have been produced by anybody. It's nothing but generic computer noises, the beat. This is the only truly bad song that Timbaland was on this year, but it's really not that bad. It's like when Pixar released Cars 2. I mean, yeah, it sucked, but the fact that it took it this long before making a dud is impressive in its own right. Also, what kind of a name is AO Technology? I mean, whenever I hear that, all I can think of is this.
So is it any wonder people are afraid of technology?
Technology!
There are so many things wrong with this song. Nelly is mixed way too quietly, Timbaland can't sing, and Justin is just being a petty little pain in the ass. But this is a good beat. And within the context of this song, it's actually kind of genius. This song came out of Timbaland's beef with Scott Storch, his underling producer who was infamous for making washed-out, tired, and lifeless beats with Middle Eastern inflections. On this song, I think that Timbaland explicitly made a more low-key beat with Middle Eastern inflections specifically to stick it to Storch and show him how to do it correctly. It's a very subtle middle finger. I like that. This song is to 2007 what Timmy Turner was to 2016. An awesome, underrated song that barely managed to scrape onto the year-end list with awesome production that turns into another equally awesome song halfway through. Also, I found this quote from John Mayer that said that he liked the laid-back, soothing interlude of the song more than he liked the more poppy, club-friendly first half of it. Which might just be the most John Mayer thing ever said in the history of Johns and Mayers. And another woman that can take your spot, my... This was my favorite song that Timbaland worked on in 2007. The production is some of the most engaging and interesting of Timbaland's career, and it's matched by some of Justin's best vocals to date. Everything comes together perfectly, and the key blending on the lead into the chorus is one of the best moments in pop 2007. We gotta do nothing crazy. See, all I want you to do is be my love. So don't give away. However, while this is my favorite Timbaland song of the year, this is not my favorite Timbaland beat of the year. That honor goes to... Now, to be clear, this is not my favorite Timbaland song of the year. It honestly isn't even in the top five. Almost all of that is down to Omarion, who just isn't a very engaging performer and is singing way harder than this beat calls for. However, if you take a second to ignore Omarion and listen to the beat itself, you'll find that it might just be the best of Timbaland's career. It has the same mystic quality as Say It Right, but with a much more melancholic feel to it. I hear this beat and I imagine standing on a mountain, looking down at the clouds below and contemplating the enormity of the world. Maybe it's just me, but I think this is one of the most incredible beats of the decade and that it was wasted on this song. Timbaland. He makes the meh songs great and the great songs legends. I'm so cold, I'm so cold, I'm so cold. I love this band so much. Come to decide that the things that I tried were in my life just to get high on. To me, the Red Hot Chili Peppers are the anti-Maroon 5. Maroon 5 has a very distinct sound, and the further they get from that sound, the better they are. The Peppers also have their own sound, but it happens to be one of the most beautiful sounds ever put to music. They've made so much music that sounds so similar, and I absolutely love all of it. The Chili Peppers are gods, and it pains me to say that 2007 was the last year-end list that they've appeared on to date, and it seems likely to stay that way. As for this song, Snow, it ranks up there with Californication and Under the Bridge as one of the signature songs from the most legendary alt-rock group of all time. What do you want me to add to this? I could talk about all the little nuances that make this song great, from the witty lyricism to the flute accents, to the fact that this beautiful guitar riff the whole song is built around is going at pretty high speeds and yet still manages to communicate the perfect laid-back vibe of the song about a fresh start like this needs, until the riff drops and the percussion kicks in and it all swells into this glorious crescendo as it begins to ponder the possibilities of what a fresh start really could mean for him. But I could go on forever. The Red Hot Chili Peppers are one of my favorite bands of all time. They have some of the most consistent quality that I've ever heard from a band, and sorry to spoil any future list for you, but if there's a Chili Peppers song on the year-end list, expect it to be on my list too, and pretty damn high at that. It took a pretty damn special song to knock one of the signature songs from one of my favorite bands off the number one spot, and believe me, we do have a very special song coming up. But first, let's get through some honorable mentions. This song is a bit too sonically abrasive for my personal taste, but I do understand the appeal. T.I. is one of the heavy hitters of late 2000s hip-hop, and this is one of his best songs. I know this isn't exactly a high bar to get over, but this gets the award for the best rap song of 2007. That is, with the exception of... She says she's about to run away and never come back. This song is the Take Me to Church of the 2000s. A really depressing, but also really powerful song that I can't believe managed to climb all the way to number 2, which I respect the hell out of, but don't find myself returning to that often because of just how bleak and joyless it is. And now for literally the exact opposite of that last song. Hey there, Delilah, I know times are getting hard, but just believe me, girl, someday I'll pay the bills with this guitar, we'll have it good. This has to be one of the simplest number one hits of the past few decades, with a lyrical conceit that's very simple. A college guy playing a song he wrote for his girlfriend over the phone, or over Skype or something. If this were trying to be anything more than a cute little love note, it would be trite and cringy. But the framing of this song forgives a lot, so I'd much rather be on the side of defending this song than attacking it. Man, Fergie's actually pretty good when she decides that she doesn't want to be the worst thing in the world. Also, I feel like I should point out that this song was produced by Will.i.am. You know, this guy. I got that boom, how to beat bang. I'ma be. Dirty bit. One of these things is not like the others. One of these things doesn't belong. Can you tell which thing is not like the other by the time I finish this song? And the award for the single most overrated song of all time goes to... Okay, before you start skewering me, then let me just make perfectly clear, I do like this song. I mean, it is an honorable mention after all. It's well-produced, well-performed, and carves out its unique identity among Rihanna songs and among songs of the era. However, does that mean I think that this song deserves a ludicrous helping of critical acclaim, to be called a game-changing force in popular music, and to be listed on Rolling Stone's list of the greatest songs of all time? Absolutely not. I do not understand the hype for this song, and I think that it's given way more acclaim than it deserves. I simply think of this as a very good Rihanna song. Nothing more, nothing less. So delicious. It's my high, so delicious. I put them boys on rock. Don't bother asking me. I don't have an answer. A really cute little pop rap duet with some nicely detailed lyrics that I wish more people remembered. This song is similar to Same Girl in a lot of ways, in that Beyoncé and Shakira find out they're being played by the same guy and they decide to get back at him. However, while Usher and R. Kelly play it off more like they're gonna throw a water balloon at the girl from their boys-only clubhouse, Beyoncé and Shakira are more like two superheroes teamed up to destroy a mutual archenemy. It's just a tad bit melodramatic, is what I'm saying. However, they make up for it with some nice production and pretty high-quality vocals, so I enjoy it well enough. Also, Shakira and Beyoncé belly dancing in unison. Your criticisms are irrelevant. Don't pretend that you didn't see it coming. To join the Black Parade. I have not listened to My Chemical Romance's 2006 cult classic album, The Black Parade. I know nothing about the album besides that it is a concept album about the final reflections of a man dying of cancer. The only song that I have heard of off the album is the title track, Welcome to the Black Parade. I only know this because it was a top 10 hit in 2007. I am not judging this song in the context of the album. I am not judging this song as part of the story that My Chemical Romance was trying to tell with the album. I am judging this song purely as a piece of music that is meant to be listened to and enjoyed on its own merits as a song. And judging it by its own merits, without any context at all, I can say with no hesitation that Welcome to the Black Parade is one of the greatest songs of all time. Every once in a while, a song comes along that is, simply put, larger than life. Some examples that come to my head from recent years are Uptown Funk by Bruno Mars and Viva La Vida by Coldplay. These are songs that, by their own merits, capture a theme or idea so thoroughly that it ascends beyond the level of a song, and every listen becomes a new experience, like rewatching a great movie or rereading a great novel. Welcome to the Black Parade is one of these songs, but it's not just larger than life, it's larger than death. When I was a young boy, my father took me into the city to see a marching band. This song is an opera about facing, confronting, and overcoming death. Because one day I'll leave you a phantom to lead you in the summer to join the Black Parade. It runs the full gauntlet of the experience. From the initial encountering of death, a concept that's too terrifying for the mind to comprehend, to the rage and fear over it, which soon morphs into triumph as he realizes that he'll never truly die because he'll be remembered by those who knew him in life. This is delivered flawlessly through some of the most impassioned singing I've ever heard in my life. I'm not a fan of emo music because it so often comes across as whiny and cringy, but in this song, it's completely justified because of what the song is about. My Chemical Romance are putting their all into it, with some of the most forceful, attention-grabbing guitars ever recorded, and several tempo and key changes placed in perfectly to capture the emotion swelling within the narrator as he accepts his role and joins the Black Parade. I could honestly make a top 10 list out of the greatest moments from this song alone, but since we've been here for a while, I'll limit myself. I won't do that. I'll only do the top 5. Combine all this with a music video that was rightfully voted to be the greatest of all time in a 2017 MTV poll, and you're left with the greatest rock opera condensed into a song since the days of Bohemian Rhapsody. I'm completely dumbfounded that this song somehow managed to chart, but I am so glad that it did. For me personally, I wouldn't call this my favorite song of all time, but it's easily in the top 20, probably the top 10. I've looked at the year-end lists for every year of the 21st century so far, and I can say that in the 11 years that have passed since 2007, we have not had one single top 10 hit that is better than this. Yeah, it's that good. Welcome to the Black Parade by My Chemical Romance, the best hit song of 2007.
Over me, and other times I feel like I should go.